Hello, good morning or good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondent Club of Japan. My name is Pio D'Emilia, and I am today moderating this press conference by Mr. Takashi Tachibana, one of the probably very few surprises about the last elections. There were not so many surprises in the Sangin Senkyo. Results were very much expected, but there are at least, in my opinion, two big surprises. The success of his party and his personal election, Tachibana Takashi, and of course the strength of Yamamoto of Reiwa, and the elections of the two disabled candidates. I think that Tachibana needs no introductions, because during the campaign he was very active, although until very few days before the elections, many foreigners, actually, they even asked me, some friends, whether he was the famous Tachibana Takashi, the one that brought to the end of Tanaka Kakuei reign. Of course, he's a different person, he's at least much younger. And I think he will be able to introduce himself in the best way, as much as he has been efficient in getting his votes and to be elected at the Sangin of Japan. So I think he will speak very briefly, and then we will open the floor for the questions. Please, Tachibana Sensei, Sensei, you're very thin.
Yes.
Please, dozo.
はい、こんにちは。 NHK をぶっ壊すでおなじみ、 NHK から国民を守る党の立花でございます。
Good afternoon, everybody. As you are aware, my name is Takashi Tachibana, representing the Party to Protect the People from NHK, known for the slogan Scrap NHK.
私は20年間 NHK で働いておりまして、14年前に NHK の不正経理を内部告発をし、その後退職をして、14年間かけて、まあ、国会議員になりました。
And so I myself worked for NHK as an employee of NHK for around 20 years. Then 14 years ago, I became a whistleblower in regards to accounting issues, accounting problems within NHK. And after that, it was when I began my current activities, and then for the past 10 years and so on, until becoming a member of the parliament today.
私のような人間が、まあ、当選するということはあまり好ましいことではないとは思っているんですけども、いわゆる潰すというかスクラップする人間でも、まあ、多くの方が NHK の問題に関心を持たれたことを、私がこれを一旦、NHK を潰すことによって、新しいものを作っていくことを国民の多くが望まれたんだと思います。その結果が今回の選挙だったと思います。
And so I think that it's actually not such a desirable thing, not such a good thing, that a person such as myself would actually be elected to the parliament, someone who is talking about, well, scrapping or crushing. However, I think the fact that this has happened shows that there are many people concerned or interested in the various problems related to NHK, and therefore many people are hoping or desiring to see what I am talking about scrapping the current NHK and creating something new instead, and that was what led to my being elected.
まあ、国会議員になってまだ4日ぐらいなんですけども、もう正直早く辞めたいっていうのが僕の気持ちで、できるだけ早くね、まあ、僕はもう NHK のスクランブル放送ができれば直ちに国会議員を辞めるっていうのを宣言していますし、辞めたいです。本当に昨日も初めて、まあ、参議院会館、あの議事堂で、開会式が行われて天皇陛下もお越しになられましたけども、ちょっと本当にあそこにいるのが気持ちが悪いので、できるだけ早く NHK にスクランブル放送をですね、実現してやめたいと思っています。
And so it's only been around 4 days or so since I became a member of the diet. But to be very frank with you, I would like to quit this as soon as possible. I have actually officially declared that as soon as I am able to realize the scrambling of NHK broadcasts, then I will indeed quit being a member of the parliament. And this is what I want to do as well. Yesterday was the first time to attend the parliament building. There was a ceremony there with the emperor and so on. But to be very honest, it really didn't feel good being there. It was quite awful. Therefore, as soon as I am able to realize the scrambling of NHK broadcast, then I will quit.
まあ、僕は今かなり嫌われてると思っています。やはり政治家って誰かと戦うわけですから、何らかの権力と戦う、何かを潰しに行ったら当然その潰している人からは攻撃を受けるということで、まあ、僕こう見えてもどちらかというと穏やかに生きていきたいタイプの人間なんですね。信じられないかもしれませんが、ですから、まあ、本当に今テレビでも顔は相当出てるとは思いますけども、まあ、いろんな人に批判をされています。今日も僕東国原英夫さん大好きだったんですけど、もうあの人大嫌いとかって言われてものすごいショックを受けてます。まあ、政治になんか理念がないっていうか、その信条がないって言われたんですけど、いやそんなもの最初からないんですよ。僕にあるのは選挙のテクニックだけですので、まあ、できるだけ早く辞めたい理由はそういうところにあります。
And so I think that it could be said that I am now quite a hated person. Of course, as a politician, you're always standing up to fight against something, to fight against authority. And therefore, if you are someone like me saying that you want to, well, scrap something, destroy something, then it is natural that what you are trying to scrap or destroy will come back against you in that way as well. However, although it might be hard for you to believe, I am actually someone who wants to live really quietly or calmly as well. I am on television, of course, very often now, but many different people from different backgrounds are criticizing me as well. For example, I was actually a huge fan of Mr. Higashi Kokubara. I really loved him, but actually on television today, he was saying that he hates me. And this was quite a shock to me, actually. The reason that he was given for this is that, well, I don't have any particular faith or belief, shall we say. However, he said that's necessary as a politician. I haven't had that from the start. I've never said that I do have that. What I do have is the election technique. Therefore, as soon as I am able to achieve my goal, then I will be quitting.
で一方で、もっともっと尊敬している橋本徹前大阪市長には、まあ、一定の評価をいただいたことがすごく嬉しくて、まあ、本当に僕ができるのはその選挙というものに関しては、今日も朝からずっと次の衆議院選挙の数字を弾いて計算をしておりました。皆さんが僕が国会議員になるっていうことは多くの方が多分想像できなかったと思いますが、選挙というのは本当に数字の積み重ねなんですね。というのは、おととしのちょうど2年前には僕は東京区議会議員選挙というのに立候補したんですが、当然落選ですし、供託金が返ってこない、もう完全な泡沫候補だったんです。もちろん3年前にも東京都知事選挙に立候補いたしまして、完全落選です。完全落選というのは当選した小池百合子さんの100分の1しか票を取ってないんですね。そんな僕が、国会議員になるなんていうのは普通に考えたら考えられないんだと思いますが、実は選挙というのは数字というのがすごく重要っていうか、少数派でも当選する方法があるっていうことを、まあ、見つけ出して実行している、まあ、もう本当に選挙の、まあ、プロというか、そういう人間なんですが、まあ、橋本さんにはそこを評価していただいたことはすごく嬉しいと思っています。
On another side, somebody who I respect a great deal is the former mayor of Osaka, Mr. Hashimoto Toru. He recently had some words rather praising of me, which is something which I found very pleasing. Actually, this morning, what I was doing was really looking at the different numbers involved in the upcoming House of Representatives election as well, and calculating, looking at different figures in relation to that. But I think if we looked back, many people probably couldn't even imagine someone like me being elected. However, elections really just comes back to these calculations. calculations to numbers. 2 years ago, when I ran for a member of the Council of Tokyo, at that time, we completely failed. And of course, the money which you put up as part of the election campaign is not returned to you. The same 3 years ago, when I also ran in the Tokyo gubernatorial elections, it could be said that that was also a complete failure. I only obtained around the number of one in 150th of the votes of Governor Koike. However, really, elections just come down to numbers. These are very important. Therefore, despite the fact that I had these failures in the previous elections, I looked into these numbers and calculations and found a way that even with a small number of votes, you can actually be successful in being elected to the parliament. I was able to find this technique. Therefore, I think I could be called perhaps an election pro. And it was that aspect that Mr. Hashimoto was praising.
僕の政見放送、NHK をぶっ壊すとか、不倫、路上、カーセックスを連呼して、パフォーマンスで票を取ったと思ってらっしゃる方がまだ大勢いらっしゃると思うんですが、パフォーマンス、あまりふざけたことをしておら、逆に票が差があるんですね。これは例えばマーク赤坂さんの過去の真面目な政見放送とふざけた時の差が2倍ぐらい出ていることや、NHK から国民を守る党の2位のドクターのお医者さんの浜田の票とふざけた岡本の票がやっぱり2倍以上の票が差が出ているということなので、実はふざけると注目はされますが票は減るんですね。でそんな中でなぜ当選しているのかっていうと、これは本当にこの NHK の集金人からの被害がすごいんです。その被害を受けた方々がわざわざ投票所に行って投票いただいた、その被害を受けた方々の数が一番多いんだと認識しています。
And during the election campaign, for example, during my appearance, during the presentations of the various candidates on NHK, there are some people that say, but because of the nature of my performances or the campaign, you know, talking about car sex on the street and adultery and so on in my presentation on NHK, that this is just a kind of performance and this is how I was voted in. However, I would also like to say that if you are appearing too foolish, well, you may have attention. This won't lead to votes as well. We can see for the example, the candidate Mac Akasaka, if you compare the times when during the broadcast he gave very serious presentations or very foolish ones, he actually had two times the number of votes when he did present more seriously. The same thing if we look at my own party as well. The candidate who received the second number of votes was Dr. Hamada, who gave a serious presentation, as compared to the candidate Okamoto, who was very foolish in, or acted foolish in the presentation as well, and had double the number of votes as well. The serious presenter had double the number of votes. Therefore, this shows that you can have more attention through such a performance, but this will not lead to more votes. So why was it that I was indeed successfully elected? I think this really shows the immense scale of the victimization of people by NHK fee collectors as well. The fact that people have suffered so much damage as a result of this meant that they went out of their way to go and vote, to go to the election booth and vote for me, and this led to my being elected.
で私どもの目標っていうのは、その NHK の番組がどうだとか、右寄りだ左寄りだとかそういうことを言うのではなくて、この突然家にやってきてお金を払えと言われることによって、それに対して、強引な集金人がいて、そこのトラブルが発生していることや、お金を払わない人には裁判までするという、このトラブルですね、こういうトラブルをとにかく解消するためにスクランブル放送をしようということであります。
And so the goal for our party, it is not looking at issues of whether the programming of NHK may be considered to be biased to the right or the left or anything to do with the content. Rather, it is about the issue of the collectors who will all of a sudden come to your home and demand that you pay money for this, the forceful methods of these collectors and the trouble that arises as a result of that. Also, the cases of, for example, people who have not paid, even being taken to court as a result of this. We want to try and somehow resolve these kinds of problems, stop these kind of troubles.From occurring. Therefore, that is why, as our goal, we are hoping to implement the scrambling of NHK broadcasts.
ですから、その被害を受けている方というのは、少数とまでは言わないんですが、少なくとも国政政党が誕生するような 2% を得票できるような被害者がいると。で、もちろん我々ワンイシューですので、これで多数派になろうというつもりはありません。国会で多数派になって、 スクランブル放送の実現の法案を通そうというつもりはなくて、まあ、憲法改正というものの大きせ、まあ、今安倍政権がやろうとしているその憲法改正の発議ですね、憲法改正に賛成するのではなく憲法改正の発議に賛成をするという、まあ、条件というかそういうその、発議に賛成するというなんて言うんでしょうかね、ちょっと表現が協力するということを武器に NHK のスクランブル放送の実現をしたいと考えています。
And these people who are well, victims of this system of NHK, well, I wouldn't necessarily say that they're a majority. It is showing, well, they were enough for us to gain enough seats, to, enough votes to have a seat in the parliament of this 2%. We are, of course, a one-issue party. We're not aiming to become a, or to form a majority within the Diet and to enact law to scramble NHK through becoming a majority or any steps like this. If we look at the issue of constitutional amendments, which Prime Minister Abe is currently trying to do, well, I would not say that we are in support of the actual amendment of the constitution, we would be cooperative in making the proposal for the amendment change, and that would be a way to bring in the condition of the scrambling of NHK broadcasts.
ここで間違っていただくいただきたくないのは特に大事なところなんで、憲法改正のに賛成と憲法改正の発議に賛成は全く意味が違います、憲法改正についてのみはだけはこの国では政治家が判断するのではなく国民が判断をする国民投票ということがこの憲法に96条に定められていますので、とにかく国民に聞くこと、最終的には国民に判断していただくっていうことが、我々もともとインターネットを使った直接民主主義っていうのをやろうとしていますので、憲法改正の発議に賛成するということは、イコール憲法改正に賛成しているというわけではないということだけは、しっかりと何度も繰り返して申し上げておきたいと思います。
And one point which I would like to make clear to ensure that there are no misunderstandings is that there is a complete difference between supporting the amendment of the Constitution and supporting the proposal in order to bring it to a vote for the constitutional amendment as well. The actual content of the amendment itself or bringing it to the people to decide upon this as well. Of course, the amendment of the Constitution is not something that should be decided by the politicians, but rather this is something which must be decided by the people through a referendum. This is enshrined within the Constitution of Japan in Article 96 as well. Therefore, bringing it to the people to ask them to decide is something which actually as a party we are proposing or using the method of direct democracy through the internet as well. Therefore, having the people to make the decision about this does fit in line with our policies. However, I would like to repeat the fact that this is completely different to actually supporting the amendment of the Constitution itself.
憲法改正だけが国民の、まあ、過半数で決めるっていう状態なんですが、我々 NHK から国民を守る党とすれば、いたしましては、いわゆる政治家の多数決ではなく国民の多数決をすれば、NHK のスクランブル放送というのも多くの、まあ、もちろん多数決をすれば多数派になるというのは確信をしております。それ以外のいろいろと聞かれるんですが、例えば原発再稼働賛成か反対かであるとか、消費税増税賛成か反対かであるとか、外国人参政権賛成か反対か、いろいろな諸問題、いろんな我々が賛否を示さなければいけないものが出てまいりますが、可及的速やかに、インターネットを使った直接民主主義、いわゆる国民の皆さんの意見が多い方に我々は議決権を行使する、そんな全くど真ん中、ちょうど真ん中というか、右にも左にもない真ん中の政治団体、まあ、政党を目指しているというか政党です。
And therefore, if the majority of the public of Japan were in support of amending the constitution, well, as a party whose sole mission is to protect the people of Japan, then we would be in support of this, if it were decided by the majority of the people to repeat. And this would be the same thing also for the scrambling of NHK broadcast. I think that we could also have the majority of the people to be in support of that. We are often asked as a party now what our stance or position is in regards to other issues, for example, the restart of nuclear power plants, the increase in consumption tax, affects whether non-Japanese citizens or foreign residents in Japan should have the right to vote and so on. These are other issues which we are being asked to share what our position is. However, as a party, we are taking the stance of using direct democracy via the internet to go along with what the majority of people voting online, what their opinion is, what they are in support of. Therefore, as a political party, I believe that we are exactly in the center. We are not to the left or the right, but completely center.
今の日本の政治というのは、まあ、与党である自民党はまさに左から右まで、悪いことをした人とかよそにいた人も受け入れるっていう方法を取っている。だからどんどん大きくなっていきます。一方で野党は、まあ、れいわ新選組がそうであったようにどんどん分裂していきます。れいわ新選組が議席を獲得した、人気を得たという報道されていますが、その分そのまま立憲民主党や国民民主党の票が減っているということからすれば、野党側の数っていうのは実は何も変わっていなくて、むしろ細分化されてしまって、どんどん与党が有利になっていっている。ですから我々はなんとか二大政党制を築くために、左右関係なくこの野党勢力を一つにまとめるために、直接民主主義っていうのを推し進めたいと、ゆっくり時間をかけて推し進めたいと考えています。私の方からは以上です。
And so within Japanese politics in general now, we see, well, in the government we have the LDP, and really within their members they have people right from the left to the right, some people who have been involved in bad things in the past, who were in other parties in the past and so on. However, the LDP is welcoming people from across the board in this way, and this is how they are growing their numbers. This is how they are increasing in size. However, if we look at the opposition, we see the aspect of them becoming more and more divided. If we look at, for the example, the Reiwa Shinsengumi, well, they were successful in having two seats in the recent election. And this could also mean that there is more division within the opposition as well. This is also votes that did not go to other opposition parties, such as the Constitutional Democratic Party of Japan, for example. Therefore, overall, there is not a change in the number of the opposition seats being held, just more division and creating more and more division within the opposition. This is something which we believe that within Japan, we do need to establish a system where there are two major parties as well. Therefore, look at how we can bring together the opposition parties to be able to become more of a, well, less divided and more of a unified force as well. And we believe that direct democracy through the internet is the method to do this. That's all from me. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Before going to the floor, can I ask you just one first question?
必要とになる前に一つ司会から質問させていただきます。
I understand the position of your party.But as a personal individual and politician, could you tell us what would you vote in case of a referendum on constitution and on nuclear power?
Constitution and power.一つ党としての立場ということは今の話でよく理解できましたが、もし可能であれば政治家の個人としてのご意見を伺いしたいんですけれども、はい、まずその憲法改正について、そして原発の再稼働について、個人の立場を伺いしたいと思います。
はい、私は、5月の堺の市長選挙に立候補して、政治家としての自分の、まあ、政治家というか立花孝志個人の考えについては、最後の機会だということで、述べさせていただきましたが、もう公党の代表として、公党として、代表としてやっていくということを決めてからは、個人の見解というのは申し述べることをいたしません。それは直接民主主義をやっていく、私はシステムを作る役割だと、この国でこの直接民主主義のシステムを作る役割だと思っていまして、政治の内容ですね、外交とか防衛とかそういう原発再稼働については、その別の方がいろいろと考えればいいと。ですから、あえて私の思想というのは公表いたしません。
In May, I stood in the elections in the city of Sakai, and at that time, I did share my own individual positions in regards to some of these issues. I did say, actually, this was perhaps my last opportunity to state these positions as an individual politician. However, since deciding to become the leader of the party and to bring that to the parliament, I have actually decided that I will not publicly announce any of my own individual positions on these issues. I see that my role now is to create this system of direct democracy using using the internet. Therefore, I would leave the contents, for example, in regards to diplomatic issues or also the issue of nuclear power plants and so on to other people. And actually, I deliberately am not going to make any official or public statement in regards to my own individual position.
Okay, open to the floor, please.
フランス店の及川と申します。与党に、憲法改正の発議と交換で、スクランブル放送をの実施を目指したいということですが、もしそれが叶わなかった場合は、例えば野党共闘で野党に加わって野党の連合の共通政策としてスクランブル放送を掲げると、そういう可能性はあるのかということが1点と、これはもう1点お願いというか申し入れなんですけれども、まあ通常、臨時国会が始まったら、まあ、週1回ぐらい野党記者クラブ主催でフリーランス開放で、まあ、定例会見をやっていただきたいなと思います。 NHK の記者も当然定例会見、来ます。それで今 NHK の記者の間では誰が N 国党を担当するかっていうことで、すごく嫌がっておりますので、ぜひそれも NHK への嫌がらせも含めて定例会見はお願いします。よろしくお願いします。
My name is Oikawa of France 10. I have two questions. First of all, is that you spoke of making an exchange between support for realizing the scrambling of NHK broadcasts and supporting the government making a resolution for a constitutional amendment or to bring that to a referendum. I would like to ask if that exchange is not possible, if that does not occur, then whether you would see it possible to form a kind of coalition with other opposition parties and to develop scrambling of NHK broadcasts as a common platform amongst the opposition. That is the first question. The second, rather than a question, it is a request. But once the extraordinary diet session begins, it is possible to once a week hold a press conference within the press club affiliated there, which is open also to freelancers. I'd like to ask you to take this opportunity and hold that weekly press conference. Of course, NHK reporters would also come there. Within the NHK reporters at the moment, there is an ongoing discussion now about who is going to be put in charge of actually reporting on the party to protect people from NHK. And of course, everybody is avoiding wanting to have to do that. So holding this regular press conference would also be a way to kind of put your pressure on NHK in a sense as well.
1問目に質問ですが、もし憲法改正とのバーターができなかった場合ということなんですが、私はもう NHK をぶっ壊すということは必ずやります。でぶっ壊すというよりも、もう先ほど申し上げた通り、NHK の人が家に行ってチャイム鳴らしてお金払ってください、こういうことをなくすためであれば、これはもう何でもやります。手段を選ばずにやります。ですから野党との共闘する可能性ももちろん今後出てくる可能性は十分にあろうかと思ってます。とにかく NHK をぶっ壊すことはやります。はい、で2問目なんですけど、どうぞ。は
い、すいません。 First of all, in regards to the first question, if such a barter is not possible, does not occur, then, well, I would want to use any method I could to achieve the scrapping of NHK. As I mentioned, what it is that we are wanting to stop is the NHK collectors going to people's home, ringing their doorbells and demanding money as well. So I would use any method I could in order to achieve that, and cooperating within a coalition of the opposition would be included. I would do whatever I could, whatever means, in order to scrap NHK.
はい、2問目なんですけども、まあ、私のようなものでもよければ、もちろんフリーランスの方もおいでいただいて、まあ、定例の記者会見をすることについては全然させていただきたいなと思っておりますので、前向きに検討していきます。
And in regards to the second one, well, if it would be acceptable for someone even like me to be giving such regular press conferences, of course I would want to positively consider to organize this, and also of course with the participation of freelancers as well.
Next question, Jim.
どうも、ビデオニュースの神保です。今回 N 国は 比例票で、まあ、立花さん13万、トータルで98万票ぐらい取られたということなんですが、当然選挙運動の過程でもいろんな方から、まあ、NHK に対する不満、まあ、頑張ってくださいと言いながら NHK に対するいろんな不満というのが寄せられたと思うんですけれども、まずまあ、この100万近くの票の中でですね、 NHK に対する不満というものは、まあ、主だったもので結構なんですが、どういうものが多かったのか、そしてそれに対してこのスクランブル放送をとにかくするということが、まあ、唯一の公約ということですが、スクランブル放送をすればその解決する問題なのかどうかという、ちょっとそのいろいろある不満と、100万票集まったものになっている不満と、そのスクランブル放送との関係というのをまずご説明いただきたいのが1点と、それからこれはもう一つ、まあ、立花さんの原点になっていると思われる NHK の不正経理の、まあ、告発の問題に関連するんですけれども、確かに NHK ではまあ、不祥事も非常に多いですし、特に関連会社なんかを経由した不正経理の問題というのは、まあ、ITECなんかも表に出てきていますけれども、実際に多い。でそこでですね、その NHK のそうした、まあ、そのちょっと選挙運動で問題にされていた不倫云々というのはちょっと、まあ、さておいてですね、実際にその経理の問題とか不正発注の問題とか、あるいは子会社に非常に高い金額で発注しておいて、まあ、キックバックを取るような問題とか、あるいはその関連会社に役員をいっぱい甘く出らせている問題とかですね、そうした NHK の、まあ、かなりガバナンスに関わる部分というのは、本来であればどこが監視をしなくてはいけない、もちろん NHK 自体に第一義的な責任はあるとしても、どこがきちんと監視あるいはまあ監査をしていなくてはならないのに、それが機能していないからNHK にそのような問題がたくさん起きているのか、その点をちょっと2点ですけどお願いします。
My name is Jinbo of Video News. I also have two questions. If you look at the results of the recent elections where, well, in the end, your party was successful in receiving 980,000 votes, close to 1 million votes actually in total. I believe that you also received many different voices from people around Japan who have various concerns or problems or things in which they are dissatisfied with NHK about as well. I would like to ask that within these different issues that were raised to you during the election, what you found was most common, what were the most common issues raised or some representative problems which were brought up as well. And in relation to this, you have the scrambling of NHK broadcast as your single platform, your single policy. However, I would like to ask whether you believe that this scrambling would actually resolve these various issues which were raised to you during this election campaign, and what is the relationship between these various problems which are raised and whether scrambling would be able to achieve or resolve these issues. The second point, excuse me, which is going back to, well, your starting point as a whistleblower about the accounting issues within NHK as well. Of course, there are various scandals within NHK. I'll put aside those which you raised during the campaign, such as adultery issues and so on, but looking at more serious governance-related issues, such as issues of accounting kickbacks to related companies, issues of ordering to related companies, and so on as well. These financial and governance-related issues. The fact that these scandals are continually occurring shows that, well, of course, there is a responsibility on the part of NHK. The agency or the organization which should be monitoring this is perhaps not functioning in that role. Therefore, I would like to ask who you believe should be monitoring NHK in this sense, who should be the watchdog in regards to that, and whether they are indeed not functioning. So these two points. Thank you.
まず一つ目の質問ですが、不満、まあ、NHK に対する不満っていうのは、私が職員をしてた時は受信料払わない人の理由って3つだったんですね。で一番多いのは今大阪市長の松井さんであるとか、大阪府知事の吉村さんがおっしゃっている、あそこが払わないから、隣が払わないから、あの人が払ってないから私も払いたくないっていう、こういう不公平なものですね。特に NHK の受信料っていうのは分担金ですので、電気やガスのように使ったら支出が増えるわけじゃなくて、見る人がというか払う人が多くなろうが少なかろうが NHK の支出は一緒なので、例えば8人で払えば10人で全員払えば1人80円で済むのに、 8人で払うと1人100円払わなきゃいけないっていう、この不公平なんですね。いわゆるお金を払わない人の分まで払う人が払わされてるっていうのが、これが圧倒的に実は不払いの理由の一番でありました。でそれ以外にあるのはやはり見ていない っていう方であるとか、逆に番組内容報道内容に不満があるって、この大体3つだったんですが、僕が辞めてからは周期人が怖いっていうようなところまで、まあ、4つ目が入ってきてるっていう状態です。で、まあ、これをスクランブルをすれば解消するのかといえば、まあ、もちろんスクランブルをすれば間違いなく解消はできると思っていますが、一方で、まあ、NHK が本来行うべき福祉番組であるとか子ども教育番組であるとか、まあ、ストレートニュース災害ニュースこういったものが全部なくなってしまっていいのかというようなところは、実際にスクランブル放送するという具体的な方向性が見つかった段階で詳細を詰めていけばいいのかなと思っています。
So in regards to the first question, when I was still working for NHK, the main three reasons which people gave for refusing or not wanting to pay the subscription fees, and these are actually similar points, or the first point is a very similar point as which has been raised recently by the mayor and governor of Osaka as well, but saying that, well, if my neighbors are not paying, it's not fair if I have to pay. If they're not paying, then I won't either. So not so much an issue with the subscription fee itself, but the fact that this subscription fee is divided between the number of people who are paying. So if we put this in an example, if there were 10 people who were paying for this, then they would be paying 80 yen each. However, if only 8 people are accepting to pay this, then they have to pay 100 yen each. Therefore, if there is less people paying, the number that they have to pay increases. Therefore, they're actually, in effect, paying for those other people who are refusing to pay. Therefore, the fact that they have to bear this extra burden means them to say, well, then I'm not going to pay either. This is the main reason which I heard from the time when I was working for NHK and still today as well, that most people do not want to pay the NHK subscription fee. The other two primary reasons were, well, one, the second, not watching NHK, the fact that they were not actually watching this, and the third, that they did not necessarily agree with the content. These were the three main issues which were raised when I was still working there. Since then, there is now the fourth reason, and that is the NHK fee collectors being very scary. This is the new reason and the new issue with NHK that many people are raising. Therefore, I think that if we look at these problems which are being raised by the people, these would indeed be resolved by introducing the scrambling of NHK broadcasts. I think that this would very certainly fix this. Of course, there would then be the issue of, or the kind of broadcasting which NHK should be providing, such as programs related to social welfare, children's education, at times of disaster, and so on. What to be done to ensure or to think about how these would not completely disappear is a conversation we would enter into after deciding how to go about the scrambling of the broadcasts.
2点目ですが、不正経理のところについてなんですが、私は NHK で20年間経理マンをしておりました。で、数字のこと経理のことっていうか、やっぱり政見放送でも言いましたけども、正直者がバカを見ない日本に戻したいというか、したい、いわゆる今の NHK っていうのはもう不正ばかりです。で、これは一つの公共放送しかないために競争が働きません。競争の原理が。ですから通常の会社は競争があるために少しでも安くしよう、払う額を抑えようとしますけども、 NHK の場合は払う額を抑えるよりも支払う額を増やした方が、その後自分がその会社に天下った時であるとか、たくさんお金を払えば、必要以上のお金を払えばたくさんのキックバックがもらえるっていう状態なので、安くしようという考えは全くありません。で、それを監視している国、公の機関、ここも同じような体質であると思われます。競争がないからです。ですから、正常にするためには国の機関、会計検査院や例えば予算を国会で承認するっていうことではなく、受信料を払っている国民に選ばれた人間が NHK の役員人事や NHK の会計の管理をする、監査をするという形にしないと、これはいつまでたっても変わらないと思っています。で、この NHK の不正経理の問題が日本全体にはびこっていると考えています。ですから NHK だけがおかしなことをしているのであれば、そこに集中的に問題が、NHK が攻撃されるというんでしょうかね、スポットが当たるとは思うんですけども、他の公の機関も同じようなことをしているので、お互いが守っている。これがまさに既得権益っていうやつですね。で、その既得権益を潰すためには、選挙でお金を使わないことなんです。 選挙でお金を使うから、その選挙で勝つためにお金を使うときに、こういういわゆるその無駄なお金を使っている企業組織からお金をもらって選挙で勝つから、そこにその既得権益に入ってしまう。だからそこに入らないためには選挙でお金を使わない。で、選挙でお金を使わないから既得権益と戦っていくことができる、まあ、そこまで考えて、我々というか私は選挙や政治をしているつもりです。ですから NHK の不正経理だけ見ていても、それはいつまでたってもこの不正経理は撲滅できませんので、必ずお金を使わない選挙で勝ち続けることによってこのような不正経理がなくなると思っています。
And in regards to the second question, I myself worked for 2 decades within accounting in NHK, and I think that this really comes down to the issue which I also presented during the election broadcast from each of the parties on NHK as well, saying that, well, we need to bring Japan back to somewhere where the honest people will not be the ones who are problematized from this as well. I can clearly say that within NHK, it is completely, well, there are problems all across the board, and it's full of scandals as well. And one of the significant reasons for this is that there is only one public broadcaster. There is absolutely no competition. Of course, if it was a company on the market where there is competition from other companies as well, they would put in efforts to lower their costs, for example. However, in the case of NHK, there is no competition. Therefore, rather than making any efforts to lower costs, actually they just look at how they can increase the payments that are making, and this will then serve in their own interests, for example, such as, you know, if they are retiring and going to one of these related companies in a position, then they can be in a good position. Or they can receive good kickbacks from these other related companies as well. There's no attempt to lower costs. Rather than this, it's actually just an increasing or using of more and more money for these kind of self-interest or these purposes as well. This is the same issue not only within NHK, but also within the government agencies who should be responsible for monitoring this as well. The fact that there is no competition, that there is no such function within the government agencies as well, means that the very same problems are also occurring there. Rather than looking at having the budget for NHK, for example, being approved within the committees in the Diet, I think that we need to look at having the people who are elected or selected by the public to be put in these positions within NHK to ensure that the money is being used in proper ways as well. These accounting issues are something, not only an issue of NHK, but things which are occurring throughout all of Japan. If it were only NHK, of course, this would be under a particular target or particular spotlight. However, the same thing can be said for all public agencies really across the board, and this is why they protect each other and keep each other's interests as the priority within this as well. This is also related to the kind of money being used at the times of elections as well, using money from these various organizations, from interests and so on, to win at elections. As long as such a system is still in place, then these interests will continue to take the front position, and therefore these issues will not be able to be fixed as well. Therefore, looking at how we can fight against this and find a system to be elected without relying on these kind of donations and so on, these interests, is indeed why I am working now as a politician. However, it's not only NHK where this change needs to be made. It needs to be, in order to be fully eliminated, this does need to be done across the board.
Sorry, before going into the next question, just a short follow-up to his first question. I don't know, I didn't follow well in Japanese the term he used, that you translated, the interpreter translated that as scary for the collectors of NHK. If you could kindly elaborate on this, because I personally was contacted by collectors and I didn't find them scary, maybe obnoxious, maybe, I don't know, but what does he mean with the word scary?
一つ目の質問と関連する質問をさせていただきたいんですけれども、先ほどの受信料を払わないという4つ目の理由で、受信に来る人たちが怖いということが挙げられていたんですけれども、司会私自身も方が自分の自宅に来た時に、怖いという印象は受けなかったんですね。どういうような意味でそういった人たちが怖いということについて、もう少し具体的に例を教えていただけますでしょうか。
はい、インターネットなどがよく出てることだと思うんですが、まずそのイルスを使う人が多いんですが、イルスを使っているとチャイムをずっと10分20分鳴らし続ける、扉を叩く、っていうようなこと、もちろん扉を今度開けると まあ、足やバインダーを入れて扉を閉めさせないようにすることを、もう契約しないと帰らないっていうような感じで脅していくと。相手が強いと思うとこれは逃げますが、弱いと思うととことん攻撃をしてくると。でその彼らの属性というのは、昔は優しいおじさんおじちゃんでしたけども、今は日本 の、 その個別訪問規制する、いわゆる特定商取引法が改正されて、いわゆる消火器を売ってた、消防署の方から来ましたっていう消火器を売ったりとか、まあ、サラ金の取り立てですね、金返せよっていう、そういう人、こういう人たちが、まあ、新聞の勧誘もそうなんですけど、法の規制によって全部 NHK に集まってきているということで、相当の被害が出ています。
So if you look on the internet, there are many different examples or people talking about this as well. But some of the examples would be remaining at the door for 10 minutes or 20 minutes and continuously pressing on the doorbell for this whole period of time, knocking on the door for a very long amount of time. Once the resident opens the door, then placing their binder in the door so that it is not allowed to be closed, so that there's no way the resident can actually close the door there, or threatening to not leave until the payment is made, for example. Of course, if they do see the resident, the person there, as someone rather strong, then they would probably give up and leave. However, if they see the person as someone weak, then they can become more and more aggressive in its sense as well. It used to be that the people who would come for these collections of subscription fees were perhaps, you know, gentle older men, for example. But now, actually, since there was a revision of the law about collecting or the door-to-door sales and so on, it has meant that people who were working, for example, there used to be different issues of going door to door to sell fire extinguishers in a very aggressive way, or debt collectors going to people's doors, even also the same often for newspaper subscriptions and so on. However, since there was a revision of the law to crack down on some of these aggressive methods and so on, these contractors or the companies who were involved in these kind of range of things are now actually all working as the NHK collectors as well. Therefore, this has meant that there is more and more people are becoming victimized by this.
ちょっと一つすいません追加、おとといも電話がありまして、NHK の集金をしていた元集金人ですと。で、特に今外国の方を狙えという指示が出ておりまして、その日本語を喋れない方は NHK にお金を払わないと、いわゆる契約をしないと、いわゆる日本から出ていけと言われると。で、そので、昔はお金を払ってもらわなきゃいけなかったんですが、今キャッシュカードかクレジットカードを出してもらえば OK なので、特にそのいわゆるこちらに来ている実習生というんですかね、とにかく日本に来ている日本語が片言の人、特にそれ寮に入っているので、その人たちを責めろという指示は間違いなく出ているということが、おとといまさに電話で来ています。
And actually the day before yesterday I had a phone call from someone who used to work as a collector of the NHK subscription fees, and what they told me is they have actually been given orders now to make a particular target of non-Japanese residents as the target for collecting these fees as well. For example, even if people say that they don't speak Japanese or they're not entering into this contract, to say, well, then you'll have to leave Japan, for example. It used to be that the payment needed to be done in cash, but now it can be done with, you know, credit or debit cards for on. However, what these targets are actually, or the orders for these targets that are being made, is particularly going to dormitories where foreign workers who perhaps have not been in Japan so long or do not yet speak so much Japanese, only speak a little bit of Japanese, but these people who are coming as trainees to Japan as workers to target their dormitories and so on for this. This was something which I heard just the day before yesterday.
Just quick follow-up. Very important. Okay. Just a quick follow-up. 立花さん、その集金人の件で、立花さんが集金人の中に暴力団関係者を使っているという発言が昨日話題になってますけど、これはもうファクトとして実際に暴力団関係者が集金人をやっているというケースがあるんですか？
A related question. Yesterday you mentioned in a statement also that there are people involved with various designated violent organizations who are working with these collectors for the subscription. I would like to ask if you could extrapolate on that.
はい、私の中学生の同級生で、まさに中学生の時喧嘩をして負けた番長が、電話をくれまして、それがもう10年ぐらい前ですか、そういう集金会社の役員をしているというところで、もうそういった中学しか出てないような喧嘩しかばっかりしかしてなかったような人間がその会社の役員をしているということで、そこから またいろいろなそこから子会社出ていってるっていうことで、まあ十分な、あ、まあ実際にやってる現場でも我々電話がかかってきますので、もう、ま、もうとにかく肩着の人とは思えない人が大勢いることは確認をしています。
Well, actually, I received a telephone call, for example, from a classmate, someone who left school within junior high school, who was always, you know, fighting, and so on. He called me around 2 years ago and said that he was actually working as a senior manager, a senior official within one of these companies, the contractors who are gathering these subscription fees as well. You know, this is someone who was always punching in the schoolyard, not going to school, didn't only went to junior high school. So the fact that he is in this senior management position within the company, I think, says a lot about the kind of organizations. And we also hear, we often even receive phone calls from the very site where that is happening as well, and we can hear these examples or these cases being laid. So I would say there are many cases of such incidents or such relations.
Albert.
I've actually had the LHK guy at my house, and he was kind enough to provide me English literature.
私自身も受診を求める人が自宅に来たことがあったんですが、その時英語での資料を優しくくれたんですね。
So look, you're a one issue politician. Considering the low voter turnout, do you think your crusade against NHK resonates so strongly with the general public that that was enough to get you elected alone? Or do you think that your success was a result of the frustration that so many voters have with the opposition party's inability to be able to get their act together?And are your voters, a second question on that is, are your voters asking you to take up any other issues aside from the NHK issue? And if so, you know, what are they and will you take them up?
2つほど質問です。まずこの間の選挙での投票率が非常に低かったということも話題になったんですけれども、投票率が低い中で当選されたということは、それだけその NHK の問題が人々に響いている、それだけ関心があるということでしょうか。それともその当選をされた背景には、やはり多くの人たちが今の野党には非常にフラストレーションを感じている、野党はうまく一緒になってちゃんと戦わないということに対するフラストレーションが人々に高いということも原因になっているのかについて、まず1つ目の質問とさせていただきます。そして2つ目の方は、実際に投票で投票してくださった有権者の皆さんから、他の問題についてもぜひ戦ってほしいですとか関わってほしいというようなリクエストがあるのか、でもしあれば、それはどういう政策、どういうことに対してやってほしいというようなリクエストをいただいているのか、そしてそのリクエストに応えることを検討されているのかということです。
はい、まず一つ目ですけども、NHK の問題と政治のシステムとか野党っていうよりも、今の政治を変えてほしいっていう両方あると思っています。NHK の被害者が多いこと、この低投票率でも当選するということは、それなりの数がいると思います。そっちの方が多いとは分析していますが、やはりこの一市民がですね、これ例えば橋本徹さんも山本太郎さんも、もうテレビでとっても有名な人なんです。でも私は全くの市民です。この市民が立ち上げた政党が当選をするということは、相当多くのこの国の国民の皆さんが日本の政治システムを変えてほしいんだと、今の与党野党のそれぞれの争いっていうよりも、政治そのものを何らかの改革レボリューションを起こしてほしいと思ってるんだと、そういう票が数十パー、20パーぐらいはあるんじゃないかなとは思っています。
In regards to the first question about whether it's the issue of NHK or frustration with the opposition parties, I believe that both of these factors are at play. I think it's clear that people do want change in the Japanese political system. However, I think that the primary reason that so many people, or that I was successful in the election, is that so many people are indeed being victimized by NHK, are experiencing these problems, and that is why, despite the overall low turnout, they did come out to vote for me. If we compare compared to, for example, people like Hashimoto Toru or Yamamoto Taro, they are, of course, people who are very well known, very famous on the television. However, I myself, I am just one citizen, not someone well known within that kind of way as well. However, the fact that as one individual citizen, I was elected, I think really demonstrates the fact that many Japanese people are wanting change to the political system in this country now as well. If we look at the different issues within both the government and the opposition parties as well, this also shows that people are looking for this reform or revolution. This is what led to all these votes.
2つ目の質問ですが、例えば警察をぶっ壊してくれとか、裁判所をぶっ壊してくれとか、PTA を壊してくれとか、水道システムをぶっ壊してくれっていうか、そのありとあらゆる改革の要望はいっぱい来ます。もちろんそんなことはできませんと、自分でやってくださいと言っています。っていうのは、これもう NHK で手一杯なんで、っていうか、でもただそれは解決方法としては、私は直接民主主義っていうのはベストではないんですが、ベターだと思っているので、直接民主主義を普及していけば、皆さんのご不満は解決できる可能性があるんではないかという説明をしています。
In regards to the second question, of course, there are many, many requests coming in asking for me to crush or scrap the police, the courts, the PTA, the water system, for example. However, I respond to all of these saying, well, no, I can't do that. Please try and do that yourself. I have enough to do in trying to scrap NHK.I don't necessarily believe that direct democracy is the best system, but I do believe it is the better system. Therefore, I am going to try and implement this to try and resolve those issues which can be tackled.
ラジオの文化放送の斉藤と申します。はじめまして。
はい、じめまして。
NHK から国民を守る党の公約としてホームページに明かされていたもう一つの大きな公約が、生活保護費は現金支給から現物支給へというものがありました。で、先日代表がお出になったインターネットの番組で、5年前の松戸市長選挙の時に掲げた公約で部下にホームページから削除するよう指示を出していたが、いまだに残ってしまっている。これは単純な私の監督不行き届きで、現在の党の公約には上がっていないというふうにおっしゃっておりました。今日思想は公表しないというふうにおっしゃっていましたけれども、なぜそう思ったのかをまず一つ教えていただきたいということと、今どう思っていらっしゃるか、そしてもう削除をするというふうにおっしゃってますけれども、今でも目立たない形で N 国党のホームページには掲載されております。これはなぜなのかということで3点お願いいたします。
I am from the radio. I have a question in regards to actually one additional policy of your party which has been listed on your homepage. And this is to change the distribution of social welfare payments from being paid as cash to actually being paid in material goods. When you were asked about this during the Matsudo election, you said that you had given the instructions for this to be deleted from your homepage as an official policy, that is not a current policy of your party. However, I would like to ask some questions in regards to this. Well, first of all, the fact that, you did mention that you will not make any individual positional comments today or from now. However, first of all, I would like to ask why you did have this as a policy in the past, what the position in regards to this now. And although you said that a direction was given to delete this from the homepage, but it is actually still remaining on your political party's homepage, I would like to ask the reason for this. So these three points.
まず生活保護、まず冒頭、ホームページに残っていることについては、本当にもうごめんなさいです、でもう直ちに私の方でも、部下経由じゃなくて、直接、今すぐ終わる次第、ホームページの業者には削除の依頼をさせていただきますので、ここに関しては本当に私のミスでございますので、お許しください。
First of all, in regards to this point still being included on our party's homepage, I would like to just say sorry for this. I apologize in regards to this. And as soon as this press conference is complete, I will actually not going through my staff, but actually directly myself make the request to the company maintaining our homepage to delete this element.
で、生活保護の問題を挙げたのは、先に後の質問を答えた方がいいと思うんで、私自身が心の病を抱えてて全く動けない時期がありました。で、この先自分が動けないというような状況に移動が続くようであれば、生活保護費を受給しなければいけない。その時に口座にお金を入れられても 銀行に行くこともできないですし、まあ、食事を作ったりということもできない。であれば施設に入れていただいて、病院にもわざわざ行かなくてもお医者さんがいる方がいい、給食を出していただける方がいい。でも心の病ですから体動きますから、まあ、気分がいいときはお掃除を一緒に手伝ったり、一緒に給食を作ったり、子どものと一緒に遊んだりっていうのは、もらうだけじゃなくて与えることもできるだろうと、まあ、今の生活保護システムっていうのはもらうばっかりなんですね。だからそれは、不正受給の撲滅にもなりますし、生活保護ってすごい大事なセーフティーネットなので、悪いことじゃないと思っているので、もっとなんだろう、この憲法25条によって保障された生活保護っていうのが病気や怪我、高齢者に、気軽に使ってもらえる制度、そして安心に使ってもらえる制度にしたい、これは今も個人的には思っています。で、まあ、5年前にこれを挙げた時にはやはりちょっとよこしまな気持ちがありまして、選挙に勝ちたいっていうのがありました。だから NHK のことワンイッシュだけじゃなくてあれもこれもっていうのがあったために、その自分の思いを乗せたっていうことなんですね。で、今年の5月の堺市長選挙では、この生活保護費は現物支給っていうのは市長選で私は訴えさせていただきました。その他の個人的な自分の政策も訴えさせていただきました。堺市長選挙の時にはかなりたくさん泣きました。演説をしていて自分のやりたい政策を言ったら演説中に涙が溢れ出てきたことが多数ありましたが、今回の参議院選挙ではそういったことは一切ありませんでした。自分の感情ではなく自分を機械に変えて、僕は政治のシステムを作る人間であって、システムの中身については別の方にやっていただくんだということで、自分のその思想を押し殺してやったために堺市長選では涙が出ましたが、今回の参議院選挙は一切涙が出てきませんでした。以上です。
And first of all, I would like to respond to the part of the question about why it was that I did have this as an issue. I myself actually had a period when I was experiencing a psychological or mental illness. I was not able to function, to operate well during that time as well. And I felt that if I continued to be ill in this way, then even if I was receiving, or if I had to start to receive social welfare, even if payments were to be made to my bank account, for example, I would not be well enough to go to the bank to collect this money, for example, or to cook for myself. Therefore, thinking about, rather than just this, to be able to have material supplies being provided instead, to be able to go to a facility and receive a meal there instead, for example. Because this was a psychological issue, it meant that physically I was okay. Therefore, at times when I would be feeling up to the act, I could also, if we did have such a system in place, for example, go and help with the cooking or the cleaning at such facilities, you know, help with playing with the children there as well, these kind of things. One of the issues, I think, with the social welfare system is that it is just unilateral receiving of this support rather than having a way to be involved or cooperate within that system as well. And so that is one of the reasons which can lead to misuse or abuse of the system by recipients as well. Social welfare as a system itself is not something which is bad. It is something which I think does need to be incorporated or implemented, and it is also guaranteed, for example, within Article 25 of the Japanese Constitution. However, I think this is looking at the methods of how to do this as well. I mentioned that I will not be making positions as an individual politician, but this is something which I do continue to believe. The reason I did raise it 5 years ago at the time of that election is because I was thinking then how to succeed in winning at the election. One issue of NHK I did not believe would be enough to have to also include these other positions as well. Therefore, that is the time why 5 years ago I included this policy within my platform. And also when I ran in the mayoral election in the city of Sakai in May of this year, I did also include this issue of social welfare payments and also other issues which I had my individual position on at that time as well. Actually, during that campaign, because I was raising many of my own individual issues, it meant often even when I was giving campaign speeches, when I was sharing my own thoughts or experiences, I would actually be crying at this during these campaign speeches. However, during this recent election, I made the decision not to be raising my personal emotions or myself in this way, but rather to look at how we can create this new political system and to focus on that issue. I will leave the contents to other people, but it's the system that I am looking at now. Therefore, this meant that in this recent election, I was not, you know, crying during my political campaign speeches and so on, suppressing this and rather looking at this one issue and how we can achieve that.
Mr. Tachibana, I think we are running out of time, but allow me a very final question.
Yes.
We have been talking a lot about direct democracy, right? And in Europe also we are talking about direct democracy. Don't you think that there are sections of some issues that cannot be brought to the people? For example, many people now is considering whether it was right or not to have a referendum in England about Brexit. There are issues that are a little bit too difficult for the people to decide. Don't you think that? And secondly, do you confirm that Mr. Maruyama Hodaka is your member now? More member, this guy?
Okay.
So suppose that his idea of staging war with Russia would be submitted to a referendum. Do you think that the Japanese people would vote for war?
これで最後とさせていただきますが、直接民主主義についての話があったんですけれども、ヨーロッパでもそれについて の議論が最近上がってるんですが、さまざまな問題の中で人々の、そういった形に託すことはできない、もう大きすぎる、難しすぎるという問題があるというふうに思いますでしょうか。例えばイギリス の最近 の EU から の脱出のブレクシット の国民投票が一つの例になるかもしれないんですけれども、人々に直接選んでもらうには難しすぎるというような問題があるのかということがまず一つ目の質問です。そして二つ目が丸山穂高議員が党員になったということなんですけれども、もし丸山議員のロシアと戦争をしようというアイデアが、もし例えば日本の国民に国民投票という形でもしかけられたら、それで多くの人たちはそれを選ぶというふうに思いますでしょうか。戦争を選ぶということですね、
はい。はい、まず一つ目の質問ですが、直接民主主義っていうのは、例えば家族に例えたらすごく分かりやすいと思うんですが、お父さんがいて、お母さんがいて子供が2人いると、この4人が選挙権があるというように考えるとすごく分かりやすいのかなと。で、お父さんがお金を稼いできて勉強、いろんな経験を積んで、お父さんお母さんが、特にお父さんがお金を稼いできて、お母さんが子どもたちを育ててるんですが、子どもの2票が、子どもたちは自分たちが遊びたいから、親のことを考えずに、例えばゲームを買ってくれとか旅行に行こうってやった時に、お母さんと組むと、お父さんどんどん出費しなきゃいけないとかなってくるので、決してこれはベストであるとは全く思っていません。ごめんなさい、そうですね、ベターではあると思います。今の日本の政治は、あまりにもお父さんが独裁しすぎているというふうに僕は認識していますので、今は子どもたちの意見も聞いていく、子どもたちというのはあまり政治に明るくない、詳しくない方、そういった意見も積極的に入れていくことが、反映することができるのが直接民主主義なのかなと思っています。ですから、難しい問題、子どもに、旅行に行くのかとか、レストランに行くのか、子どもたちはイエスノーとはっきり言うでしょうけども、今の子どもたちに質問で、例えばアメリカのトランプさんどう思うとか、そういう、トランプさんが好きか嫌いかとか、多分子どもたち分からないと思うので、そういうものは危険をするのではないかなと思いますが、いずれにしても政権与党になって直接民主主義をするというのは僕はちょっと違うのかなとは思っています。ある程度まで大きくなれば、 直接民主主義っていうのはやめるべきだとは思っているんですけども、ちょっと回答になっているかどうか分かりませんが、こんな感じです。で、どうぞ。はい。
First of all, in regards to the question of direct democracy, if we were to use the example of a family, if we say we have the father, the mother, and two children, and all four people have the right to vote in this, of course the father has various experience. He is perhaps the one who is out earning the money for the family, and the mother may be the one raising the children, and so on. And the children, of course, you know, when they had the opportunity to vote, they might want to, you know, play. They might want to vote for buying computer games or for going on a holiday, for example. And this would mean that the parents would have to pay more and more money for these things which may be voted for in this way. Therefore, I wouldn't necessarily say that this is the best system. However, I do believe that it is the better of the options available. I think that the issue, the problem at hand now within the Japanese politics today is that the father in this example is having too much power, almost as a dictator within this decision. Therefore, we need to look at how to have some way for the opinions of the children, although they may be not so familiar with the big issues, to have their thoughts or their opinions somehow reflected within the policies as well. Of course, you would have a different situation if you were asking the children, you know, should we go to a restaurant or should we go on a holiday? You can have a yes or a no very clearly from them from that. But if you were to ask them, well, what do you think of President Trump in the United States? Well, they may not necessarily have their position on this, and there may be chances where they may also, you know, choose not to vote for that particular issue, for example. However, I would like to also say that I think that this direct democracy method is something which can be implemented when you are a party on the size or the scale that we are now, perhaps, as we are developing in this way. But it is not necessarily something which would be maintained, for example, if we were to grow into a larger party or to become the government. You know, if you were forming the government, then this would not necessarily be the way to continue the managing of the party.
2つ目なんですが、まあ、結論から申し上げれば、日本は武力を行使してロシアを奪おうという考えを持っている方は圧倒的に少ないと思っています。で、そのまあ理由根拠についてですが、まあ、憲法改正をすることができたんですね。2016年から今年の7月まで、憲法改正、まあ、憲法9条を改正することの発議、まあ、できたというか発議はできました。3分の2を初めて超えました。その期間も安倍政権は、自民党は憲法改正の発議をしなかった。それはおそらく国民投票を模擬的に何らかの方法で調査した結果、憲法改正の発議をしても国民投票では通過しないという圧倒的な数が調査結果が出てるからだろうと思います。かつ今の日本はとっても豊かです。表面上は本当に豊かな国で、僕は投票率が低いということは素晴らしいことだと思っています。選挙の投票率が低いというのはそれだけ豊かな国であると、安全であるというふうに考えていますので、この我が国日本の人が、国民が、国民の多くがというか少なくとも過半数の方が憲法改正やましてや武力によって他国の領土を奪おうという考えは持っている人は少ないと認識しています。
And in regards to the second question, well, to state the conclusion first, I think that it would overwhelmingly be the minority of people in Japan who would want to use force against Russia, to wage war against Russia for territory. If we look, for example, at the issue of the potential constitutional amendment of Article 9 of the Constitution, Prime Minister Abe could have raised the resolution to go to a referendum, did have the two-thirds of the majority required to do that. However, the fact that he didn't make the decision to actually go to the referendum, I believe, is probably because they were carrying out some kind of survey of public opinion and showing that this would not pass, that people would not, the majority of people would not select this amendment of Article 9. I think that on the surface now, at least, Japan is a very wealthy country. And in this respect, actually, the fact that there was such a low voting rate in the recent election, I think, is a wonderful thing. It shows that for the majority of people, people see Japan as very safe, very rich, and therefore they do not necessarily feel the need to go to vote in that sense as well. So this is something which I think should be praised. Whether they would also support using force to go to war and so on, I also do not believe the majority of Japanese people would support that.
Well, thank you very much.
Yeah, welcome.
So, thank you. Since you said that you didn't like very much the atmosphere at the Sangin, and since we are very close, from there.
あの議員会館の雰囲気はあまりあのよくないということで、まあ、ここから
when you feel particularly bored or, you know.
あの、まあ、つまらなくなりましたら、
you can always come here.
またこちらの membership for 1 year. お越しください。1年間の名誉会員
になります。Oh, 食堂 is much better.
Thank you.
議員会館より食堂が美味しいということです。
Thank you very much. Thank you.